Our next story is supposed to be introduced by Ife with the music, but let's calm down. Tory Lanez allegedly blames drunkenness for Meghan Thee Stallion shooting incident in a sorry test. The test is reported to have been sent to Meghan while she was still in the hospital. It's read, and I quote, "I know you're probably never going to talk to me again, but I genuinely want you to know I'm sorry from the bottom of my heart. I was too drunk. Nonetheless, things happen. Should never have happened, and I can't change what I did. I just feel horrible because I genuinely just got too drunk." End of quote.
I think this is the part where Erica and Tory Lanez need to do
come together, yeah.
A remix of Blame It On The Alcohol, because they are both affected by this right now. So, yeah, too sad, but it's not an excuse to shoot anybody. We've seen drunk people that will not even drive.
At least, when you're drunk, why you need to, they don't have gutter, they fall into the gutter now. Why are you shooting people?
You know, or sleep in your car, or why do you have bodyguards? Why do you move around with entourage when you would still
why
get
do you
drunk
have a
at the
camp? You that's not licensed. Let's talk about that.
America. That one would be difficult to talk about.
As a celebrity that you've seen all of your friends, your colleagues go down on that. See, but sometimes when we want to do, like, it's kind of ironic now because I was just shouting, do you, in the first story. Sometimes when you are doing you, you have to be aware of the choices that you want to make and the consequences that come after that. I know our generation and, like, younger people like this idea of, like, you know, we can do whatever, we're really invisible. And I think that he has that problem. Even when he started his music, he came out with Bryson Tiller. And I used to jam to his songs and I used to follow his personality. And I could see that he lost me when he started to get a lot more, I don't say fame drunk or power drunk, I don't know what it is, or money drunk, but he just started getting really callous with how he was and how he interacted with women and all that type of stuff.
His gangsterism.
Yeah, all this gangster stuff. It's just getting too much. And it's okay. People can say, you had your fans for that or whatever. But there's consequences to feeling invisible. And I think it's not just alcohol that you're going to blame. I think your mindset as well. Alcohol cannot make you something that you're not.
To enhance who you are.
Thank you. So I feel like that's something that he needs to... Yes. And I feel like that's something that you need to really think about. The alcohol apology was too much in there. I feel like you need to own up and take responsibility for your action, become more accountable. How are you going to actually work on this, you know, attitude or mindset that you have, and then we can start talking. But either ways, what has been done has been done.
Like you said,
and you know,
but in this whole conversation, nobody's still telling us the real tea. Was Tory and Meghan dating?
It was speculated, yeah. And then
they need to give us the full tea, please.
I don't know.
Meghan.
I think it's safe to say they
Tory.
Were.
Okay. Why you Meghan? No, why? I don't understand. Career wise or
Tory,
what wise?
Height-wise.
Of course, now nah. Tall ladies can actually date.
Not just men. Tall.
It's
like
probably tall in the right areas.
Wow.